All right.
Whoa,
I can't see anything with those on. So I came here for the free cocktail that Jack promised me.
You got it.
It was okay, thanks. I drove from my job at the library in my all-electric Leaf and came here and chose songs, reviews by probably soccer moms about the Bruno Mars Unorthodox Jukebox album, because I thought, well, fuck, I'm dressed like a soccer mom, I might as well do that. I don't know anything about this album, sadly. I don't know anything about most of the stuff that Jack showed me, and I chose this and, of course, Tammy Wynette, because I know who Tammy Wynette is. You know, I studiously do not follow any kind of modern music at all, although I like Neutral Milk Hotel. All right. So here's Mary Black going off on Bruno. What a waste of my money. This CD is vulgar. I partially listened to it once, realizing what mistake I made. I will never listen to it again. I'm sorry, Mary, if you partially listened to it. You have not listened to it. The last song could have been great. But Jill, way too X rated. Also capital first letters. Not enjoyable to me. It's turned me off to him. And that was not capitalized. I don't know. Let me just say this. People writing on the internet, just get Grammarly or something. Just learn how to fucking use the English language. Capital letters go at the beginning of the sentence, not all throughout the sentence. When you write a whole word in capital letters in one of these reviews, I am gonna start shouting. Is this really, am I really loud? Am I deafening everybody? Catherine Mary Fiffle, PF, very shocked. I'm 54 years old and I fell in love with the first Bruno Mars CD. I loved every song on it, period. So, capital S, when I heard about a new Bruno Mars CD coming out, I pre-ordered it, just knowing that I would love this one as well. Because I'm sticking with the soccer mom thing here. Kim D says, and that's a lowercase Kim and a lowercase D. X-rated! My kids, 7 and 12, love Bruno Mars. So I bought this so we could listen to it in the car. This is all about sex and lots of cursing. What a waste. Totally not appropriate for my 7-year-old. Actually, I didn't even enjoy listening to it on my own. Sorry, Kim. Learn how to capitalize your name. All right. Now we're going to Tammy Wynette, someone I actually know and have listened to. And this record was called The Definitive Collection. Tammy, in case you're wondering, the fantastic country singer, and she's dead. This is by Frank Johnson. He has a thing or two to say. He says, other than a few Wynette genuine classics and a couple great duets with the peerless Mr. George Jones, this collection is the furthest thing from definitive I have ever heard. A version of Every Breath You Take with Sting? This sounds as if Tammy recorded her vocals in Nashville and Sting recorded his vocal in a studio in Italy, which is probably the case. I couldn't believe my ears. How absolutely horrible! That was all caps. And hip-hop track that ends the disc, please. This is the most god-awful thing imaginable. If Tammy were selling out to the big green god this badly in her later days, it's no wonder she's no longer with us. That's in bad taste, Frank. Don't waste your money on this monumental piece of dreck like I did. I think I'll back over it with the car. And then Bill Moore, he has something to say about Tammy Wynette's definitive collection. He says, the first song is great, the second song is less great, because it's like the first song.
Which was great.
Bill, the third song, dot, 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 capital N, need I say more? I'm sorry. People need to learn how to spell. And I like Tammy Wynette, especially when she and George Jones are being repetitious. I don't think that's a word. But by herself, maybe office music for a Southern divorce lawyer's meeting. Well, I just want to say I probably would rather be in a Southern divorce lawyer's waiting room than hanging out with Bill Moore or Frank Johnson. That's it for me. Avengers are